They also cover a lesson coming.
She is having some extra class. Transformer. As the name suggests, it will transfer something. Former means the previous one. So indirectly it transfers some previous signal. So actually it is a device which, simple topic, important one, which works on principle of mutual induction. So there is one MCQ which they can ask. Transformer work on principle of dash, eddy current, mutual induction, self induction, amplification. So you should know it works on the principle of mutual induction and produces alternating voltage or alternating current. From alternating voltage means you are giving alternating, you are getting alternating. From alternating voltage or alternating current. But of desired value. That means it is not changing the nature, it is only changing the magnitude, but of desired value. If output voltage is greater than input voltage, then it is called as step up transformer. That means it will increase the output. If output voltage is less than input voltage, then it is called as step down transformer. So from this part, one MCQ you can expect in your board exam. What is step up? What is step down? What is principle? Something of this type. Right, this much.
Dancer.
Okay. Construction. It consists of a soft iron core on which two coils of different turns are wound. The coil across which output is obtained is called as secondary coil, and the coil across which input is connected is called as primary coil. Okay, write this much.
Done.
Now diagram, then working. This is called iron core. Here we have a coil wounded. This side another coil of different turns wounded. Across this output will be obtained. Here we connect alternating source, AC source. So this one is called primary coil and this is called secondary coil. Suppose here EMF is E1, here E2, N1, N2. copy. Diagram done?
Yes.
We are interested in relation between EMF and number of turns. So let N1 comma N2 be primary and secondary turns of coil. Phi1 comma phi2 be flux across primary and secondary. Let E1 comma E2 be induced EMF across primary and secondary respectively. N1, N2 are turns in primary and secondary. Phi1, Phi2 are flux. E1, E2 are EMF. Let phi be flux per turn associated with each coil. Therefore, by Faraday's and Lenz's law, E1 is minus d phi1 upon dt. So minus d by dt of n1 into phi, which is flux per turn. So this will be n minus n1 d phi upon dt, equation 1. Copy first again till this mark.
डाउन सर।
E2 will be minus of d phi by dt. E2 will be d by dt of n2 phi. Therefore, E2 is minus n2 d phi by dt equation 2. Therefore, E1 upon E2 will become n1 upon n2. Case 1, step up transformer. For any transformer, E1 upon E2 is N1 upon N2. Now we are obtaining condition if transformer is step up. That means E2 will be greater than E1. So E2 upon E1 will be greater than 1. That means N2 upon N1 greater than 1. N2 is greater than N1. Therefore, secondary turns are greater. So, for step up, secondary turns are greater. Copy. Case 2, step down transform. E2 is less than E1. E2 upon E1 less than 1. N2 upon N1 less than 1. N2 is less than N1. So secondary turns are smaller. Ideal transformer. Ideal means there is no loss. Whatever you give, same you get as output. A transformer in which output power is same as input power is called as ideal transformer. So since input power is same as output power. So E1 upon into I1. Power is EI, so E1 I1. Output is E2 I2. So E1 upon E2 is I2 upon I1. Also, E1 upon E2 is N1 upon N2. Therefore, E1 upon E2 is I2 upon I1 is N1 upon N2 for ideal transformer. Right. Done?
Yes, sir.
Note the ratio N2 upon N1 is called as transformation ratio. Generally, ratio is 1 upon 2. This is N2 by N1. Efficiency of transformer. The ratio of output power to input power is called as efficiency of transformer. Therefore, efficiency equals to output power upon input power. Percentage efficiency is output power
upon input power into 100.
Okay.
Now come to page number 498. Page number 498. First objective. All textbook objective, please practice before your exam. First
you month, will be helping us, right?
That will definitely help. At least 20% MCQ will be same.
Yeah, I'm asking, you will also be helping us, right?
No, I will to help because your exam is early enough for Wednesday. Afterwards, I will see, I'm now EMI doing. Then it will come AC, then electromagnetic wave. So this will get over then November 29th is your exam. So all after completing this, I will not start new chapter. I will do only revision from first chapter. And then after exam, I will start with new set. So in that revision, I will be helping you.
Even during exam, right?
During exam also, I will help. I will be there throughout till your exam gets over. This I was suggesting till Wednesday what to do. So for that, you revise all your textual MCQ. I will be there with you till your final exam date. Don't worry. In electromagnetic induction, induced charge does not depend upon. What is formula for induced EMF? Can you tell? Formula for induced EMF. What is formula for induced EMF?
D phi by dt.
This is general formula in magnitude. Okay. But here we are interested in charge. E is nothing but IR. Just wait. I cover about chiller. So wait.
So our lecture will end early today, right?
IR is EMF. IDT will be D phi by R. IDT is nothing but charge. D phi by R. So charge does not depends upon what? It depends upon flux, yes. Resistance, yes. It does not depends upon time. It does not depends upon time. That is option B. Second one, a metal rod moves with constant velocity perpendicular to the length at constant. A constant field is in the direction perpendicular to the rod. So there is field in the rod. Select the following. Entire rod is at same potential. No, there is potential difference developed. In this case, if I see by Fleming's right hand rule, index finger inward, thumb upward, current is to the left. This is direction of induced current. So current is induced means here we'll get plus, plus, plus accumulated here, minus, minus, minus. So this point P is at higher potential than Q. So they're telling entire rod is at same potential? No. One end is higher, other end is lower. There is electric field, yes. Because if one side is positive, other side negative, there will be electric field from positive to negative. So option B is correct. There is electric field throughout the rod. There is electric field in the rod. Done first and second?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Third. The current through 1 millihenry coil. 1 millihenry means 10^-3 henry. Drops from 5 ampere to 3 ampere, so changes 2 ampere. In time, 10^-3 second, what is EMF developed? What is formula for EMF developed? LDI by DT. L is 10^-3, current is changed to 2, DT is 10^-3. That means E is 2 volt. Option C. Third over?
Yes, sir.
Four. When current in a coil.
Sir, by the way, what do you think about the second exam, like semester two?
Second exam will be slightly difficult.
Because Darshit sir said that he and some others are talking, and he thinks that most probably this exam, the second exam will also be offline, because considering the situation we are in right now,
online you're saying. Second exam will be online, you're saying, no?
Yeah.
See, I predict it won't be online. Reason for that, they are planning to start all the school colleges from November. So if they start for at least 1 week also, then they will continue. So everything depends upon your exam when it starts. What is the situation during that period?
But in 2 months, nothing is going to be that good that they are able to take exams and keep up.
It's not like that. Huh? This is relative. Now, if they splash the news on the channel that cases are increasing every day, then everything is worsening. But if they say last 10 days there is no cases, then everything will be normalized. Now, today only I saw news that 1 crore 25 lakh some vaccination they have done. So, if there is vaccination completed throughout, then I don't feel there will be a problem. Now, in this.
Students are not getting, right? Because we are under 18.
No. If there is no cases, even if students have not got, but all the teachers teaching the student, all the staff coming in contact with the student, if they are vaccinated, then there is no need for student to get fear. No? So at least trial and error, though, they will do, because 2-3 places they have started the college. Because conducting online is not easy, because then real talent is not checked. Offline is they can check your ability, everything. Online is just formality. So no student should get panicked in the final exam. Therefore, they have conducted this. I1 is 8, I2 is 2. In time, 3 into 10 raised to minus 2 second. Because chances are there, Supreme Court will come out with a verdict. If everything is right, why you are closing the colleges and schools, students are getting hampered with the studies.
I don't think so, because considering what happened last time, all the parents were against it, and a lot of even some of the actors were supporting the students, considering the cases rising so quickly.
No, but right now, from last 10 days, cases have not increased. In spite of
there are a lot of cases
opening things. When you say cases, it should be like this. Today, suppose it is 5,000. Tomorrow, it should become 7,500.
Sorry, I didn't hear you.
See, it should be like drastic change. Suppose today there is 500 cases. Tomorrow, if it is 505, next day again it comes to 400. Then they can start. But suppose now train is on, festive is on. Still the cases, if they feel, are not rising. Now they are only waiting what will happen to the third. Now in US and all, they have started everything. But in hybrid manner, 4 days college, 2 days online. Same thing they may start at our place also. 3 days college, physically functioning, and 2 days offline, because yesterday there was debate on that. If they start offline, then there will be placement coming in the colleges for engineering. Last year, there were no placement. There are 4 lakh engineers not getting job. So they said, unless until Supreme Court allowed, we cannot do anything. So there was debate yesterday on news. So I personally feel that after November, if third wave means October, they are thinking there may be this again cycle getting changed. If that doesn't come, it will be offline. Because online study is actually time pass. A teacher cannot see student cannot see teacher. Half the time, he is not in mood, no interaction. So that interaction is very much essential. Now, if people get habitual to this, then this will become trend. But I personally feel this all things are only useful at higher when a person is matured and is having no time. Now it is developing skill when you interact with other students. Your thought, his thought will match, contradict, then you will discuss, then you will flourish. Huh? बट वी आर ऑल नाउ इन कंफर्ट जोन कि घर के एटमोस्फेयर में सब हो रहा है विच इज एक्चुअली नॉट करेक्ट. अप टू सर्टेन एज यू हैव टू एक्सपोज योर बॉडी टू ऑल दिस सराउंडिंग, नहीं तो इम्यूनिटी भी वीक हो जाएगा. करंट इज 8 to 2, टाइम इज दिस मच एंड EMF इंड्यूस्ड इज 2 volt. सेल्फ इंडक्टेंस इन द कॉइल विल बी हाउ मच? EMF इंड्यूस्ड इज L, चेंज ऑफ करंट अपॉन टाइम. सो 2 इक्वल्स 12, करंट इज चेंजिंग 8 टू 2 मीन 6, इन टाइम 3 × 10⁻², 3 × 2 = 6, L इक्वल्स टू 2 कैंसल, 10⁻², हेनरी. They want answer in mini Henry, into 1000 Henry, that is equals to 10 milli Henry. So option D. Fourth done?
Yes,
sir. Fifth, self-inductance of straight conductor. Straight conductor, it is not in coil form. So current cannot be changed within this. Self-inductance of straight conductor is zero. Sixth, a coil and a bulb are connected in series. A coil and a bulb are connected in series with 4 volt DC source. 4 volt DC source. When soft iron core is inserted in the coil, light emerging from bulb will increase, decrease, remain same, or become off. Here there is soft iron core. Due to this iron core, there will be flux. And if there is flux, there will be induced EMF, the light emerging in the coil. See which type of source it is? DC?
Yeah.
That is no change in current? Hence, no change in flux. Flux will be developed, but no change in flux in iron rod. Therefore, induced EMF is zero. Therefore, voltage before equals to voltage after insertion of this iron core. Therefore, brightness will be same. No change in voltage, brightness is same. All very short answers of the textbook that also revise. So only an MCQ will be created from this only.
Done?
Yes, sir.
Seventh one. A solenoid and resistance R are in series to a battery through a switch. Solenoid. And a resistor are in series through a switch. Through DC source and switch. When switch is put on, current I flows through it, varies with time as shown in the graph given by. Okay. When switch is on, then current flows, which is varying with time. So whether it is increasing, it will become in a parabolic form, or decreasing, we have to analyze. We will study further. Solenoid is inductor. When current varies, when it is put on, then current will flow and there will be resistance developed. If resistance developed, that means total current will start decreasing. So it is found that current is voltage upon resistance. Here, this resistance is due to this plus of this solenoid. Both are inverse. So when current is passed, this goes on increasing such that voltage is constant. So is it like I into total resistance is constant wala case? So whenever product is constant, then it will be always this type of graph. Product is constant. This is called rectangular hyperbola. So whenever you see two things are constant, remember it is rectangular hyperbola. This will be the graph. Seventh option C. Come to page number 503, first numerical. First numerical. The area enclosed by circular coil of 2000 ton. N is 2000 ton. It is enclosing area of 10 centimeter square. That is 10 into 10 raised to minus 4. Meter square. Its plane is perpendicular to the field, which is 0.3 Weber per meter square. Rotated through 180 degree. Calculate the change in flux. Initially perpendicular, then rotated by 180 degree, flux is how much change. So this is coil. This was first the flux perpendicular. Perpendicular. So I can say initial flux phi 1 is NAB. Final flux phi 2 is NAB cos of 180 degree rotated by 180. So NAB minus 1 minus NAB. Therefore, change in flux, comma d phi is phi 1 minus phi 2. So d phi will be NAB minus of minus NAB. 2 times NAB. 2 into 2000 area, 10 raised to minus 3, yield is 0.3. So 2 into 2, 4 into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to minus 3, 0.3. So final answer will become 1.2 Weber. This answer. So 1.2 Weber. N is 200, answer something like 0.3. Turn twice NAB, area is 10 raised to minus 3, N is 2000 into 0.3, that is 1.2. Option wrong, the other answer. One second. Completed.
Yes.
One more we'll do, then we'll stop. Second one. Magnetic flux through the coil of 50 tons changes from 0.3 Weber to zero in 1 second. Calculate EMF induced across N. This is nothing but N times change in flux. N is 50, flux is 0.3 minus 0 upon 1. 50 into 0.3 equals to 15 volt. Computer now?
One, sir.
Okay.
None.
So today we stop here.